director of the club, Pete Kowalski.
Thank you, Bob. Welcome, everybody, to our fourth annual end of season in the middle of tryouts, before the Wrangler, in the middle of everything else going on in Wrangler. So yes, we are crazy. We talked about this last year to try to pull this off around when everything else is going on. We are insane, but we're excited that you guys are here. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to have a drawing right now for the raffle. Can I have your attention? And the winner is... Just kidding. I just want to get your attention. Okay, first of all, I'm going to be very quick because we've got a lot to go over tonight. We're going to recognize some winners, some volunteers, some very special people for the club, give out some awards, and yes, we will give out a pretty big check at the end of the night. As of right now, the amount in the raffle is a little over $13,000. So for those of you that are math majors or have hung out with the mathnasium mascot, you know that's about $6,500 for somebody here tonight. Okay? Before we decide, I just want to recognize a few people that have spent a lot of time pulling this thing together. Ray, I want you to stand up real quick and hold your applause. Gary Gardner, stand up. Guy Garshula, stand up. Noel McCain, stand up. Todd Pittman, stand up. Holmes, stand up. These five fine folks pulled this together, so thank you very much. Field watching a high level game, and here's all you have to do. attention headquarters. The referee just fell down and can't get up. Send the referee to the assignment. Or, attention headquarters. They just kicked the ball in the woods and it's now lost. And we need another ball. Please send a ball. So the point is we need 400 field marshals. And here's what you're going to get. Everybody that signs up for a field marshal position and they serve in that field marshal position for one game during the regional tournament at the end of June is entered into a drawing. And the drawing is for an entire year of fees for your child. That's right. An entire year of fees for your child. So if you want to be entered in that drawing, you need field marshals. And the way you can find out how to be a field marshal, go to our home, go to our website, go to our social media, and sign up, because next week we'll be seeing a lot of announcements on how to sign up to be a field marshal. That's it for that. Okay, that's about all I've got to say, everybody. My next special guest, Sarah Rose. Okay. But before we do that, we're going to have a lesson. Mason Clay, please come to the stage.
Volunteers from UNCG, NCAAT, Page High School, Union City Middle College, and we tutored about 15 kids that normally wouldn't get any academic support. Some of you can see some of the stats on the tables. Another big thing that we do is we host the Summer Soccer Fest. Last year it was called the Soccer Marathon. A couple of people won free dues. A couple of teams won free tournaments. That is going to be August 11th, and we'd like for people to sign up for that again. You'll see more information at your team meetings. It's a great way for you to raise money this year. The money, instead of going to your team, the money actually goes to your individual dues. So last year, the percentage went to your team. This year, it actually goes to you. So it's free money. We hope you'll sign up. And lastly, we want you to know a lot of people are looking for volunteer hours for schools. We need volunteers. We need volunteers to help coach. We need volunteers to help tutor. If you can read and do simple math, you can come out in one day, maybe more than one day. But we have some really exciting programs, and so we hope that you participate. Before you throw out your old uniform or your cleats, see if you can't donate it to the Kicking In for Kids program or like Cole and Coolidge. Before you look to get rid of anything, we have a lot of kids that need school clothes, and so a lot of times we get items that kids can wear as part of their school uniforms. And then finally, we ask for you just to pay attention to not only the USA website, but also the www.usafoundation.org, as we offer a lot of exciting things on there. The foundation wouldn't be possible without Cooper United, and so I want to, even though we have a lot of people that don't want to be thanked, I want to thank James Seidler and Joe Brown for coming out on Saturdays and helping with kids. I want to thank Melissa and Nathan Joseph for coming out. I want to thank Cole and Paige for coming out and also running the Kicking In for Kids program. And with that being said, I'll stop and I will call up our awesome Saturday soccer coach from 5-6-year-olds and 10-12-year-olds, and he'll make it happen. English is optional, and it is President Joe Brower.
Thanks, Sarah. I just wanted to give a quick update on some of the things that the board and the staff have been working really hard on. Kate mentioned the fact that we have a variety of new fields and facilities investment that has occurred in the last year. And the theme for the board and for the club has been investment not only in the fields and in the facilities, but also in our personnel. And we've taken great strides in doing these things. About a year ago, we sat down collectively as a group to really think through the strategy of the club and also focus on those areas that we needed to improve and those areas where we could deliver a better product for our kids and for our families. He mentioned the investment in fields. I think most of you have seen what's going on at Bryant Park. We still have some other things we need to invest in, Smith in particular. But the other thing that we spend a lot of time looking at is the organization. And as most of you know, a year ago, we hired Scott Brinson to be our executive director of soccer. And that was the byproduct of us taking a long, hard look at the organization and evaluating every aspect of what we were doing, from curriculum, from kind of how we interacted as a club with the fusion, the number of teams we had, what our supplemental training programs were, and also what was the best organizational structure for the club. We've been in a very deliberative, but frankly very hectic process over the
group. They had a lot on the plate. Soccer-wise, to hold us together is nothing short of miraculous. So thanks to you guys. Also aware of the huge amount of volunteers that put countless hours in to make any of these events happen. And we thank you. Moms and dads, families, thank you. The commitment you made to the organization from a time standpoint, from a financial standpoint, getting your kids to ASD, giving up the evenings, none of that is lost on us. And I can assure you we work every day to give your product in return that's reflective of your commitment to us. So thank you. To the kids, they're probably running crazy around here somewhere. And you guys are the heartbeat of this. And you guys are what makes it tick. But tell your moms and dads thank you. This doesn't happen easily. So tell your moms and dads thank you tonight when you get a memory. So exactly 1 year ago today is when I received a call of the offer of this position of Grand Rapids United. There was a lot of people, mainly my family, didn't think I would ever leave here today. I've been there for 18 years, I've played there for 4 years, I had a tremendous love for the University of Providence. And I don't think there's many jobs that I would have left for. But there would have been no UCG. None of that would have existed had I not had my youth career, which was right here in Greensboro. So really, I can attribute any success I've had to coming through the same path that many of you are going through right now. And the ability to come back in a leadership role and hopefully enhance that experience for anybody in this room is something I, quite frankly, couldn't turn down. So a huge thank you to the board, James Heichler, who's outgoing president, Joe Brower, current president. Thank you for the opportunity to lead. So, that being said, July 1, here you go. This. So I want to thank the staff because these guys are a tight-knit group. It's not easy to have somebody come in from the outside and into a leadership role. And when they embrace me and make me feel welcome, I can't thank them enough. And a special alum that monitor, Pete Monsky, of course, God, and I work very closely with every single day. And I can assure you, as an organization, you couldn't find two finer people, never mind soccer aspect, two better people to work with your kids day in and day out. They wake up every day, go to bed every night, truly thinking about how we can make this a better organization. I can assure you of that. So we're in good hands. I know they got sick of me asking them question after question after question, but they stuck with me. So thank you. I'd be remiss if I didn't thank the people that really make this organization sick. Any of you that volunteer or spend any time around Bryant Park know this is a true state. And I don't think the poor ladies are even in here tonight, but Kathy Cartier, Wendy Burns, Vicki Vaughn, those ladies absolutely work tirelessly in that office. They keep all of us straight. I'm blessed tonight to sit with Kay Mills and Terry Harden, who did that for many, many years. When I was a young coach, they used to point me in the right direction. I guess I'm not a young coach anymore, but thank you to you. But truly, those ladies, it's unbelievable the amount of work that they put in. So as Joe mentioned, one of the things we've been charged with is putting together a 5-year vision of where we need to get. I say we, because I certainly didn't do this alone. The entire board, but two members in particular, So what does additional staff mean?
Well, we have to limit the number of people that our directors have to oversee in order to improve their performance, improve coaching education, and have more hands-on for your kids. Ultimately, we have some fantastic people in this room that work on our staff right now. Many of them are stressed extremely thin. Many of them wear several different hats in terms of their job. And it's hard to cover all the areas that are necessary in each of their jobs. So by the increase of the staff, we can hopefully limit what they do and really allow them to hone in on what's important. And what's important is getting the best product we possibly can to their kids. We've maintained these goals. It's not going to be easy, and it's not going to happen overnight, but if we can do it incrementally, year by year, it's certainly an attainable goal. We need everybody in this room to be on board and supportive and get us where we're trying to go. One of the other things that this investment will hopefully do, and please, if you hear nothing else I say, please hear this time. We want to win. I'm an extremely competitive person, and I want to win. I want this organization to win. There's a misconception in youth soccer nowadays that de-emphasizes winning. And I want to be really clear with this. What U.S. soccer has put forth is not to tell anyone that winning is not important. Winning is important. How you win is a different story. And I will never instruct any staff member to go against any of our core values, any of the things that we want to do developmentally to do the right things for our kids. We're not going to forego those in lieu of winning, but winning is important. So my task now is to get out and find the right people to join our excellent staff to help us achieve these goals. And I truly believe, and you well know this, any organization is only as successful as the people that we have involved. So in addition to finding the right soccer people, just the ability to find the right people in general that can come in and bolster this organization. There's a lot of talk these days about curriculums, style of play, all those things that certainly are important, but I truly feel that we've got a pretty good grasp of that as an organization. And moving forward, it's the people that we bring in to implement those things that's far more important. As I said, and I'll close with this, the most important people in this room are the ones that are probably not listening to a word I'm saying, and those are the kids. But when you're in the office all day, and you're dealing with emails, and you're dealing with phone calls, to get out on the field and have a bunch of kids who care less about that stuff, it's pretty refreshing. And I think that's what makes us all tick. So thank you. You guys, if we never get to the point where that's all we have to worry about, we'll be pretty successful. Like I said, this job came about. I'm the luckiest guy in the world to have landed it. So thank you to everybody in this room that's made it possible. I can assure you that myself and this fantastic staff of ours will work every day to make this place better for you, your families, this entire organization. Thank you again for the commitment that you made, and we hope to continue to get better and better each day. Enjoy the night. Todd Pittman has worked tirelessly to put together a fantastic video for us that we're going to transition into now, so you don't have to listen to me talk anymore. But once again, thank you. Gary Carter has instructed me that this is in no particular order, so if you think your team is already done, they're not, so please pay attention to the video. Thanks again. Have a great night. Thank you. Jeremy and Carrie from the office for all those years. This club, quite honestly, may not exist if it weren't for all the work they did over the years. So in their honor, we have this award. Mr. Coach Gallagher Duo is here with me to present our Manager of the Year for the Classic Select and the Academy. So for the classic level, we have
one of the things that's so special about Greensboro United is we have something for every kid, the most elite future professional player down to the kid who just wants to get out there and run around and have fun. And so, we're not done with our coach of the year, so we want to bring up Andrew Fleming.
Guy, you got to
represent the recreation coaches of the year. Next up on our list is the Community Impact Award, named
Nathan is more than a boy that needs a wheelchair or a walker to go places. Nathan has an infectious smile and a true need for speed. Nathan's mother told me it often took a long time for Nathan and Monty to set up cones that Nathan would then navigate with his ball, dribbling the ball while using his walker. They are a big temptation for the other kids and even got picked up in an attempt to be played with elsewhere. Lawton was protective of what he and Nathan were creating while also being sensitive to the other kids who were excited about the cones. I was incredibly impressed by his maturity, sensitivity, creativity, patience, and kindness. And most importantly, Nathan had the time of his life. His constant laughter was indicative of that. Please join me in congratulating the top soccer buddies of the year, Kaya Alcock and Lawton Gresham.
these teams have had tremendous seasons, tremendous success. Yeah, give them a hand.
Terry worked for us for how many years?
Like 3 times.
Third grade leaders.
I'm gonna split that with you when I'm there. I'll take care of you.
Just in case.
S. Justin.
S.
Are they present? She is!
Soleil Diller. 12-girls Celtic, Audrey Flynn Craig. 12-girls Chelsea, Abby Rose. 12-girls Crew, SOR, Isabella Worley. 12-girls Royal, Olivia Head. 13-girls Dino, Isabella Ringley. Girls Navy, Annabeth Merritt. 13-girls White, Izzy Medino. 13-girls Red, Morgan Crenshaw. 13-girls Royal, SOR, Montserrat Hercules Enriquez. 14-girls Dynamo, Raven Preston. 14-girls Navy, Hannah Jane Christman. 14-girls White, Jessica Oberlies. 14-girls Red, Eliza Stallings. 14-girls Royal, Isabella Villarin. 15-girls Navy, Christina Layton. 15-girls White, Haley Williamson. 15-girls Red, Lucy Zerfoss. 16-girls Navy, Leonard Young. 16-girls White, Zoe Howland. 17-girls Navy, Elena Aileen Carpin. 17-girls White, Devin Riley. 18-girls Navy, Roger Taylor Dean. 18-girls White, Katie Southwick. 19-girls Navy, London Rose. 19-girls White, Katrina Dick. Those are your girls' teammates in the year. Yes, stay on stage for me, please. Girls, stay on stage for me. Listen to the nice photographer and then stay on stage. Matthew Creech. 12 boys Navy SOR, Simon and Roscoe. 12 boys Royal, Davis Lowborn. 12 boys Royal SOR, Jacob Eden. 13 boys Dynamo, Nathan Zamora. 13 boys Navy SOR, Brady Brownell. 13 boys Navy, Ben Pratt. 13 boys White, Gabriel Wagner. 13 boys Oil, Henry Mayer. Yeah, 13 boys Oil SOR, Sullivan and Trajan. 14 boys Dynamo, Jacob Wood. 14 boys Navy, Dylan Machard. 14 boys Navy, Anthony Jim.